Hi, and welcome to this demonstration video over the SysConfig development tool for Texas Instruments C2000 real-time microcontrollers. If you're not already familiar with SysConfig, please check out our SysConfig video series for an in-depth information about this feature-packed tool. My name is Ryan Ma, and in this video, I'll be showcasing how you can use SysConfig to transition across different C2000 device families through a step-by-step demonstration. Before I move on to a live demonstration of the migration, I will give a high-level summary of the steps that I will take to transition device families. For this video, I'll be using an already existing example project called Universal, which can be found within the latest C2000ware software development kit. This example project will incorporate features such as linker command tool, clock tree tool, and device support module. Once we are ready to migrate to any other device, we can easily do that with a click of a button. In order to migrate across devices, there are new modules that you will see added within the Universal project. First is our clock tree tool that will generate our clock configurations, handle any system clock errors that are not aligned with our datasheet, and provide a graphical interface of the device's clock configuration. Next, we have our device support, which will auto-generate any device initialization files that are required for the specific device we are on. After that is the linker command tool that will help configure our memory through a graphical interface within SysConfig. When we switch across devices within SysConfig, a migration report will be generated that will validate all the settings being ported over to the new device. To start off this demonstration, I'm going to open up the example universal project found within the C2000ware for the F28004X device. Now that I have imported the universal project example, I can open up the project properties to see that I am currently on the TMS320F28049C device. We can build the project to view the generated source and reference source files. The files that are now being auto-generated are the device initialization files, the system clock configurations, the linker command files, and any SysConfig-related files. Now let's open up the generated source and reference source by clicking on the drop-down arrow. An important auto-generated file is the board.cmd.genlibs. This file will pull the correct driver lib needed for the device automatically through a compiler linker option. The device_cmd.cmd file will contain the memory configuration generated through SysConfig. Let's go ahead and close the generated source and view the reference source. Under the reference source, we will see the code start branch file that will be ran after our boot ROM code. Now we are ready to go over the migration with the click of a button through SysConfig. If we wanted to switch to any other device during our development, we can easily do so within the SysConfig tool. I'm now going to open the universal_c2000.sysconfig file. Within SysConfig, I am going to go to the device view by clicking on the chip icon. Then I'm going to click on the switch button and select another device. In this video, I will choose TMS320280013X. I'm going to go ahead and select the biggest pin package and click confirm. Once the switch has happened, SysConfig will generate a migration report that will walk us step by step on how to resolve these errors. We can view this migration report by clicking on this icon. With this migration report, we can see that there are memories that no longer exist on 280013X that existed on 28004X. By clicking on the hyperlink, I can go to exactly this error is occurring. Now that I see the error, I'm going to select the correct memory to load the text from, which will be LS0 and LS1. There still seems to be a few more errors that I will need to resolve before I see the auto-generated code. Once I have fixed all the errors, I can go ahead and save the SysConfig file. Once I save the SysConfig file, I'm going to see the dialog box pop up that will let me know when CCS has finished auto-migrating the project properties. This is a very quick step, and I can go open the new project properties. The variant and core have now been updated with the new device I wanted to migrate to, which is 2800137. After viewing the project properties, now I'm going to rebuild my new project. Once this finishes building, we can view the generated source and reference sources to see that they have been updated with the correct device. Now we have successfully migrated across devices with just one click. This will conclude demonstrating migrating across device families with just one click using SyskConfig. We were able to leverage the automation and compatibility validation built in through the SyskConfig tool to migrate efficiently. Other training resources can be found in the description below this presentation. Thank you for watching.